So you see me backtracking runway 32 at Bruny Island Airport. I've just about to take off for home. I've had a very enjoyable morning taking the scenic route through New Norfolk and Hobart down to here, and having a cup of tea and a chat to Tim, and then off I go home. Good news is that talking to Tim, that the Bruny Island Airport people and the council have had their meeting, and it looks as though the airport is going to stay open, which is enormously good news, because it's the nicest place really for a short trip where I can land somewhere else rather than just go for a fly and arrive back on my own airstrip. It's always nice to go somewhere, stretch your legs, and then come home again. So jolly good news all round. So, round we go. We'll get ourselves ready and plant it at the beginning of runway 32, and we'll do all of our pre-flight checks, and then set one stage of flaps for the takeoff, and away we'll go. And we'll have a look and see what the air's like once we get up there. Well, as you can probably see from the takeoff, it's a bit bumpy up here. So I think what we'll do is we'll head off to the west and go across the Doncaster Channel, and then hook ourselves round over the water and head off following the western coast of the Doncaster Channel and to the south, and come in along the Huon Estuary and head for the entry to Windrush Airport from that position directly. So rather than going over the top of the land and putting up with all the seriously rough air I suspect there's going to be over the hills and the folds in the land, we'll get what shelter we can by staying on the water. Well, I'm not getting much relief from the turbulence by staying over the water, so I don't see any reason why I shouldn't cut the corner here and cut over the last little part of this lowest part of this little promontory and shoot up the Huon from there. So that's what we'll do, I think. So that little island that you can see at the mouth of the river around about 10 o'clock in front of us is Huon Island, and I believe there are two or three houses at least on Huon Island, so somebody obviously lives there. We'll wait for a nicer day and we might go and have a look over the top of it and see what there is to be seen. So looking to the right, about 2 o'clock is the entrance to Signet, Port Signet and Signet proper. I'm sure I've said this before, but Signet used to be the most important town of this part of the world in the days before the bridge was built at Huonville, which made Huonville the obvious place to build a major town because of it provided access to both sides of the Huon River. But Port Signet and Signet have quite a long history. Quite nice places. They run a delightful folk festival every January at Signet. Really very, very good. Brings heaps of people into the town. Quite a greeny sort of town, you know, a bit sort of aged hippie type place. But extremely pleasant place to go. And on the left, at about 2 o'clock in the river, you can see some of the nets that the Huon aquaculture used to grow salmon and/or trout. I'm not sure which. Along the Huon River, they tow those around from time to time so that the defecation from the small fish, being rather intensively farmed, is spread decently around the river. Good for the employment in the area, as both forestry and agriculture are losing workforce. The aquaculture is bringing some in at least, and some money back into the region. Now, as you can see, I'm starting to lose a bit of height here. I'm hoping that by getting down below the tops of the banks of the river here, I might get myself a little bit of shelter from the wind. You never know, always hope. So you can see straight ahead, just beyond the bend in the river, the sites of the wharf at Port Huon, which is where we're heading for to make our turn eastwards towards Windrush International. And we're down fairly low by this stage, but I don't think we're really getting much benefit from being below the banks of the river. I think we're just going to have to live with the bit of turbulence that we've got today. It isn't really that bad, but it's less pleasant than it might be otherwise. And you can see the Port Huon jetty just to the left of the nose there. We're almost down to our turning altitude, and just beyond that point we'll make our turn to the east and start the final approach into Windrush International Airport. So you can see Windrush International off to the right, straight ahead of us as we turn in, and we're going to put down full flaps, slow down, and come in as slow as we reasonably can, given the turbulence, a little bit faster perhaps than we normally would, but low and with a reasonable amount of power on, so that we can climb rather than flare as we reach the runway.
8.2.